Hello friends and welcome back to the horror section. This is going to be a review video for Honeymoon Horror. And I thought this one was a pretty cool little slasher movie. I believe this was made in 1982, if I'm not mistaken. But I thought this was a pretty cool little slasher movie. It starts off as this couple and they kind of own this little honeymoon suites on this island. You can stay at these cabins when you get married and stay there for your honeymoon and all this stuff. And the husband, he's going to head off to the mainland, maybe. I noticed him getting in a boat and he's starting to head off. But as he's heading off, the wife goes into the guest room. And, of course, there's a guy in there and that's like one of their friends. And she's been messing around behind her husband's back with this guy friend. And, of course, the husband, he comes back because he forgot something. Well, he's like, where's my wife at? And he hears some noise up there in that kind of back room or whatever. And he kind of breaks his way in. And, of course, he finds them together and he gets in a fight with the boyfriend, with her boyfriend. And they pretty much get into a big fight or whatever. And then the husband's pretty much doing pretty good, beating the boyfriend up or whatever. And lo and behold, the wife hits, I guess she's afraid that the husband was going to kill her boyfriend or whatever. And she hits him over the head with a bottle, kind of knocks him in the floor. And when it knocks him in the floor, kind of knocks him out. And he knocks over this lamp and the lamp starts a fire. And instead of, like most people do, trying to save him and get him out of there, and let whatever happens, happens, they pretty much just leave him in there. And it pretty much burns everything down. Well, it jumps like a year later. And lo and behold, they're married again. The lady is, she actually marries the boyfriend. So her husband's dead, so she marries the next best thing, the one that she was messing around with behind his back. So they open the the island honeymoon cabin thing they got going on there. They open it back up. They kind of build it up, fix it up, and then they're going to have these people come there and stay there when there's, after they get married. Well, at first there's three couples that's going to come, but before that these three co-eds that work for the, that are, in the sorority. I mean, they're kind of coming up there to fix up the cabins for their sorority sisters. Cause it's their, I guess their wedding night and their honeymoon and all that. So they don't want to fix it up, make it look good. So they actually come there and they kind of fix it up. Well, lo and behold, there's this killer, since this is a slasher movie, that starts killing the three girls off in kind of gruesome ways. There's some pretty good gore, some pretty good, killing scenes in this one, or I enjoyed it pretty good. It has some pretty good little deaths in it. And of course they get killed off, and then I think the maid gets killed off. She kind of gets killed off kind of behind the scenes, and you might see her later on. I think they find her body. And of course here comes the three couples. There's three different couples there, and the husband and the wife, or the new husband and the wife, are still there. So you still got quite a few people to go through here. And of course there's the there's also a little bit of comedy relief. There's the there's a sheriff on the mainland and the deputy, and they're pretty much just there to be, I don't know, just have funny scenes. Some of the scenes are kind of funny, and then, but most of it's just kind of cornball. It's not real funny to me, but it's just a little bit of comic relief. Somebody that I've heard kind of reviewed this movie before said that was actually added in later on. Like, this is brought to you, as you can see at their top, by Sony. And Sony kind of added that in, the cop scene, or the sheriff scenes, just to make it kind of funny. I'm not really for sure on that. But that's what they heard from the director of this one. But that was just added in to make it a little more funny, because it's kind of gruesome or whatever. But, and of course, the couples come there, and they start getting, a few of them start getting killed off one by one, and it kind of leads to the end. This one's got a little bit of a mystery in it. There's there's a mentally challenged like helper. He goes around, fixing stuff. So could he be the killer? Could one of the co-eds or one of the their husbands be the killer? Could who's the killer in this one? It's got a little bit of a mystery to it. But if you've watched any slasher movies and you watch the first part of this, you're gonna realize pretty much who the killer is. You're gonna get to the end and say, "Oh, well, that's who I thought it was." So I don't really want to give it away, but it's not that difficult to figure out who the killer is in this one. But I mean, we've watched slasher movies before where you get to see the killer kill the people. So that's not really going to hurt nothing. But like I said, I thought this movie was pretty cool. It's got some good kills in it. It's got a little silly comic relief in it, a little bit of a mystery to it. It's just a kind of a fun 80s slasher as we enjoy them. I thought it was pretty good. It's got a kind of good concept going to it, This island where you can't really get off of it very good, and it got a few people to get killed. You've seen some movies where there's just not very many people that get killed in it, and there's not enough people to actually. This one's got quite a few people to actually dispatch one by one, and they do a pretty good job with some good kills and good gore in it. So I really like this one. So if you're looking for an old-fashioned kind of slasher movie with a little bit of fun, a little bit of silliness, a little bit of corny and cheesy kind of fun, then check out Honeymoon Horror. I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a pretty good one. So that was a pretty good movie with some pretty good kills in it. So until next time, have a good one and see ya.